The long-awaited day is finally here. The Svelget team just announced release Svelget 1.0, which means it's finally production ready. For those of you who are unfamiliar with Svelget, I will briefly go over what it is and some of the out-of-the-box features it provides. Then I'll show you how to deploy a Svelget application on Vercel in under a minute, as well as the added benefits you get when deploying Svelget applications on Vercel. Finally, for those of you who are familiar with Svelget, I'll go over a few of the recent changes as it looks quite different today than it did just a few months ago. So let's get started. So Svelget is a newer framework for building web applications that's been gaining popularity due to its performance and simplicity. It's built on top of Svelte, so you can think of it kind of like what Next.js is for React, and it really simplifies the process of building and deploying applications. Now, Svelget comes with server-side rendering, which is great for performance and SEO. It makes building static sites super simple, which is great if you're building a blog post or a marketing site, anything that's really content-heavy. It has TypeScript support and also hot module replacement, which allows you to see all of your changes in real time without loading state or refreshing the page. Now, Svelget also has some amazing out-of-the-box features, such as its directory-based routing. It has a super intuitive layout system, server-side rendering, and a really unique and convenient way of loading data into pages and layouts through what we call the load function. Now, before we dive a little deeper into a few of these features, let's first get an application up and deployed on Vercel so we can reference it throughout this video. Now, with Vercel, it's extremely simple to get started with Svelget. We can go to the Vercel template marketplace, search for Svelget templates, and select the templates we want to use. Then we just click deploy. Now Vercel will deploy this template for us in just a matter of seconds. While this process is finishing up, we can expand the logs and watch the build process as it happens. And I also want to mention that Vercel supports GitHub, GitLab, and Bitbucket with native Git integration. However, you can also use your CLI or API to deploy your code. We just try to make it as easy as possible to get your code off your local machine and into the cloud behind a URL. All right, so now our app is deployed and we can go check it out. So here we have our live site, and it's behind a default Vercel domain, but if you have a custom domain, you can update that in the dashboard. Now, let's make some changes to the codebase so we can explore some more of Vercel's cool features. Here I've created a new branch where I added a new page at the /Vercel route. So back in our command line, let's push these changes up to Vercel. Now my code has been sent to Vercel, and thanks to Vercel's automatic Git integration, anytime a new commit is made, it's going to recognize this commit, kick off a new build, and start the process of building our app and deploying it out to every region in Vercel's network. Since this was pushed to a branch rather than main, you can see by the URL that we're looking at a preview deployment. Now, if we click it, we'll see in addition to our newest changes, we also have this toolbar at the bottom of the screen. Here you can either share with your team or make it so anyone who has a link can log in and start leaving comments. So, for example, we can leave a comment up here, and we can even attach a screenshot if we wanted to, thanks to the Chrome integration. In the sidebar, we can view all the comments as well as mark them as resolved. So now, let's say this branch has been reviewed by the team and all the comments are resolved, so we're ready to deploy this to production. We could merge the branch into main, which would automatically redeploy main with the updated code, but we can also promote this branch to production in our dashboard. So back in our dashboard, we can click these three dots and we'll have the option to promote to production. So let's go ahead and do that. Now listed here are all of our deployments, and unfortunately, every now and then a branch may get merged into main that introduces a bug or decreases performance. In these instances, we want to revert to a previous stable commit as fast as possible. Vercel provides us with instant rollbacks, which allow us to instantly roll back to a previous deployment without rebuilding. For example, if we want to roll back to this deployment, we just click the three dots and we can click roll back. And now our site is instantly rolled back to the stable deployment without having to rebuild the application. So if we once again check out our production deployment, we see that we've rolled back to our previous deployment and our new Vercel tab is no longer there. Vercel also provides analytics for your web app. By adding Vercel Analytics to your project, you're able to visualize your app's core web vitals, as well as gain insights into your audience. Here we can see data such as the total number of page views, the top pages being viewed, browsers being used to view your application, and more. By deploying your Svelget apps on Vercel, serverless functions are automatically configured, and we can view our function logs here in the dashboard. If we visit our production deployment and enter a word into this Svrtl game, back in our dashboard, this function is logged. What's even cooler is that Svelkit also supports Vercel's edge functions, which allow you to run JavaScript code on their globally distributed edge network. This means you can serve your users dynamically rendered pages at the same speed you would serve static files from a CDN. Now, there have been quite a few changes made to Svelkit in the past few months, and a good amount of them were breaking changes. So if you've used Svelkit in the past, you might find it feels quite unfamiliar today. Let's go over the most notable changes, the first being the change to Svelkit's file-based routing. Previously, any file added to the routes directory would automatically create a route at that name. So for example, creating the page in our routes directory called about.svelte would automatically create a page at /about, and adding an index.svelte file would create our root page. Now, all routes are directory-based, and the old index.svelte has been replaced by +page.svelte. This new convention ensures that you are deliberately creating a route, and eliminates the need for the old naming convention that required you to use underscores in order to co-locate non-page files in the routes directory. With the new routing changes came major changes to the layout system as well. Instead of naming our layout files __layout.svelte, we now name them +layout.svelte, similar to our pages. Previously, we could have multiple layouts in a single directory using named layouts, such as index at about.svelte, which we have since said goodbye to. In addition to these changes, a new grouped layouts convention was added, and this allows us to share layouts within group directories, which are folders wrapped in parentheses. Group directories do not affect the path name of nested routes, but acts as root routes for layouts. There have also been some big changes made to how you load data into a page. Previously, the load function would be called in a page component's context module script block, and the return data would become available to the page as a prop. A page calling the load function would have looked something like this. Now, Svelkit has completely gotten rid of the context module, and the load function has moved into the endpoint file. Now, a page file can automatically load data from its sibling +page.js route by exporting the strongly typed data prop. Loading data into a page the new way would be done like this. First, we need to create a page.js file that calls the load function. And then within our page.svelte file, we just export our data prop. Now, the data returned from our load function is available via this prop. As I mentioned earlier, data is strongly typed, so in this example, data would be typed like this. Now, these are just a few of the most recent changes made to Svelkit. If you want a more complete list, I recommend checking out the migration guide, which I will link in the description below. If you want to learn Svelkit in more depth, Vercel has a complete beginner Svelkit course that's free, and I will also link that in the description below. Otherwise, that is all for now. I hope you guys enjoy building with Svelkit, and if you deploy any of your projects to Vercel, link them in the comments below because I'd love to check them out.